Yes, the humming jaguar. So if we check for some, hear that? Everything's connected. But what happens, what I've figured out, it's the treble boost. That's amplifying a noise that actually exists. There's a tiny bit of hum even in the passive mode. So, we don't like it like that. We need to fix that best we can. So I guess it's getting all taken apart. And we're going to shield things. And I got a feeling there's another ground wire that can be attached. I've got a bunch of communications as to how to fix this up. So if anybody's got any other info, please pipe off. But right now, it's getting new strings anyway. So we're taking those off. And I think I'm going to take the neck right off it just so I can work on this a little easier. And I got to touch up the headstock, so it'll just be easier to do both. So let's just do that. I decided I'm gonna touch up the headstock first. Oh, would you look at this mess? Oh no. I think this is the one I want. It is too. It seems to be gooched. I managed to bring it back
Shit.
to life. For this application, that'll be fine. So that's lacquer in there, case anybody guessed. This is probably most likely some sort of poly finish. It appears to be a little too slicked, I think, to be lacquer. But this will work. Trust me, been there, done that. Fantastic little brush, these guys from Lee Valley Hardware. Need a little bit of this tinted amber. This lacquer is really thick too. And underneath the magnifying glass, and we're only going to put material where there's actual damage. We're not gonna get it anywhere else. That's why I'm using the big magnifier. This will do two things. Your eye won't go there anymore. It won't hone in on it. And it'll also stop any more material from flaking off or chipping off in that area. So there we have it. That's round one. I'm getting some better light on there. I might do another round. That's fairly respectable. Cool. Okay, so now because I took the neck off, I can set that aside and we'll rip apart the circuitry and see if we can get rid of the hum. I'm going to save this little brush for round two if I go there. Okay, let's get at this thing. There's a lot of screws to remove here. Oh, look at all those lovely wires. Interesting. Okay. And they do have it looks like the shielding paint is in there. So we're gonna have to see what's up with this. I gotta take everything off it. That blob of tape doesn't look like a factory item to me, but I could be wrong. The way this is spinning around, take this off. There's no need for this. What the heck did they do to me here? Okay, so here is what is going on. This is conductive shielding paint in here. You can hear the continuity beeper beeping. But they didn't join the cavities. So this ground or this shield paint isn't connected to the ground. And why am I not getting continuity there? I should. Yeah, there we go. So this, and I could probably get a little better camera look here. Sorry, guys and girls. See, this circuit, that ground should be connected to this shield, and it doesn't. So I think the best thing to do is probably just to reshield the whole thing so that the shield comes up over the edge a little bit and touches these, and then we'll make sure that we run wires to connect the cavities together, and I bet that's going to do away with a lot of it. That's what I'm going to do. Okay, let's begin. So the theory here is, if I come up over the edge a little bit with my shield, so it comes in contact with all these control plates, which are all connected together and connected to ground, that should ground the cavities. One little bummer is I had to peel a foam out from underneath the circuit board, so I can do that. And I guess the only other thing that's going to be weird is, I guess, to do the pickup cavities. This one's really tight. I don't even know if there's enough room to get the shielding foil in there. But we'll try. So just to let you know what's going to go on here, is I've overlapped the shielding so that when I put the pick guard back on, this shielding is going to make contact with that shielding. And holy smokes, they had it half right. I guess I could have cheated or tried to basically just connect all the cavities together, which is what they didn't do. And they didn't connect the conductive paint to ground. So they tried, but I don't know. Okay, so since I had it all apart, I'm just going to shield it with copper and be done with it, and make sure that everything is joined together. I may even see how it works without shielding the pickup cavities and just see if I've gotten anywhere before I pull all that out. Holy smokes. Okay, more work. Okay, great success. So now this plate is grounded to the cavity. Look at that. And I put that little jumper in there. So I'm loving it. A little more shielding. Okay, so I popped the back pickup out of it and shielded that cavity, even though it was already painted with shielded paint. I guess in retrospect, one of the comments that I received about this is that I could have just, you know, ran jumpers in the back and connected all those cavities, but I had the copper shielding stuff, so I figured, what the hell, it's all apart, might as well do it. So now, just to understand what they didn't do, is they shielded all the cavities, but they didn't join them together, and then they didn't join that to ground. So we would be under the impression, after all this fooling around that I just did, we're not going to have any noise. So let me get all the screws back in it, because that's holding things together. That's going to make everything connect together, because I ran all those little loops in the back side of the pick guard and all that fun stuff. Hang on, here we go. Okay, it's all back together. It's plugged in. And all terrible hum's gone. What it is, what there is happening though, and I'll just say this, if you boost the treble up with the active thing in on, you know, I hear a little bit, but I mean, these are single coil pickups. There's going to be some noise, and all the preamp is going to do is amplify that noise. And that's my story and sticking to it. We did finish off the job that the Japanese people didn't finish for me, which was connecting all those control cavities together. And like I said, I don't think I really needed to get in there with all the copper, but I had it, and I did it anyway. So that's that. It's all shielded up. We cured that dilemma. And I think the next thing, and maybe I'm just going to do another video. We'll put it back together and set it up. And that'll be another part to the Jaguar. But I'm really keen on hearing how this sounds now that I cleaned up all that noise. See, listen. Oh, isn't that nice? Oh, wait a minute. It's always silent when the amp's off. Come on. Oh, the amp was on. Okay, that's passive. And that's active. And that's what the treble boosted right up. And bass boosted right up. I'm thinking it's cured. Cheers, folks. Ah!